This year marks the 70th anniversary of the People's Republic of China. Over the past decades, the country has risen from shambles into the world's second largest economy.
It now has the world's biggest middle-income population, and it's the largest contributor to global economic growth.
It is widely acknowledged that a key to China's success is its system of democracy, which results in political stability and vitality. You might need an encyclopedia to thoroughly understand the system, but you can see how the Chinese democracy works by following an annual event that takes place in Beijing, the two sessions.
The two sessions are the annual meetings of the country's top legislature, the NPC, and top political advisory body, the CPPCC National Committee.
In Chinese, democracy is called Minju, and it means that the people are the masters of the country. But how exactly does China's democratic system work? And how can its people's voices be heard? Let's check it out.
Shen Jiyuan from Shenzi is a lifelong farmer and China's longest-serving national lawmaker. In the early years after New China's founding, Shen proposed equal pay for equal work between men and women.
The clause was written into the country's first constitution when the NPC held its inaugural session in 1954.
Yao Ming, an NBA Hall of Famer, is a CPPCC National Committee member. In 2014, Yao suggested the government scrap unreasonable administrative approval procedures to benefit competition organizers.
Yao's suggestion was later turned into government measures,
as the country is determined to turn the sports industry into an $800 billion sector by 2025. The idea that migrant workers in cities should receive unemployment insurance was proposed by Zhang Chaoqing during the annual session in 2017. Zhang, a migrant worker and an NPC deputy, saw her suggestion come to fruition in the same year, which benefits tens of millions of migrant workers.
These figures are only three out of tens of thousands of national legislators or political advisors. China's NPC deputies and top political advisors work pro bono. They have full-time jobs in addition to participating in political affairs.
To fulfill their duties, the lawmakers and advisors spend countless hours gathering the opinions and expectations of the people that they represent.
每年，我统计了一下，我整个三分之二时间是不在我的办公室，在天津地头。上班的时候，在等红绿灯的时候，碰到一些送外卖的，跟他们了解一下他们的一些情况，这些情况都是我们履职的。From
2013 through 2017, deputies raised more than 41,000 suggestions.
在这次全国人大代表会上，我将以绿色发展产业振兴乡村文化提交立案。我这边主要带来的提案是关于二元返乡创业的双创这一块，更进一步的把咱们双创的一些政策具体的再落到我们底层的创业者身上。
我从自贸区开始的时候所提到，应该在中国建立，在上海初创，那是2012、13年一个大会书面发言一个提案。我当代表的五年的话，提了20个建议，现在回想起来，基本上事事都有回音，渐渐基本都在落实。Each
of China's national lawmakers and political advisors has a story to tell. NPC deputies and CPPCC National Committee members consist of top leaders, renowned economists, entrepreneurs, artists, sportsmen, and representatives from all walks of life.
As President Xi Jinping said, democracy is not a decoration, but a means of solving problems. China's People's Congress system and multi-party cooperation and political consultation are different from other systems. The people as masters of the country is the essence and core of socialist democracy.
As national lawmakers and political advisors gather in Beijing this March for their annual sessions, We'll be looking forward to hearing people's stories and learning whether or not their expectations were met.